We begin, though, keeping him honest with President Trump. We'd intended to lead the story by saying that he'd gone the entire day without tweeting once about the Russia investigation or any other of the more than half dozen inquiries now underway into virtually everything he's touched. That's what we were going to do. Then he tweeted just after 6 p.m. Eastern, quoting the president, "New York State and its governor, Andrew Cuomo, are now proud members of the group of presidential harassers. No wonder people are fleeing the state in record numbers. The witch hunt continues." He's talking about New York's attorney general doing what the president once said would be a no-no, at least if Robert Mueller did it.
Mueller was looking at your finances, your family's finances, unrelated to Russia. Is that a red line?
Would that be a breach of what his actual
I would say yes. Yeah, I would say yes.
Well, now we don't fully know how far Mr. Mueller has gone in his pursuit of Russia evidence or whether he's crossed that particular line. However, New York State just did. The attorney general's office issuing subpoenas, according to a source familiar with the matter, to Deutsche Bank, seeking records relating to the Trump Organization and a number of high-dollar loans and lines of credit. The attorney general also wants to see documents relating to a failed bid to buy the NHL's Buffalo Bills. And if that sounds familiar to you, there's a good reason why.
I am giving to the committee today 3 years of Mr. Trump's personal financial statements from 2011, 2012, and 2013, which he gave to Deutsche Bank to inquire about a loan to buy the Buffalo Bills and to Forbes. These are exhibits 1A, 1B, and 1C to my testimony.
That obviously is Michael Cohen's opening statement to the House Oversight Committee just last month. He was talking about what he said was the president's habit of inflating or shrinking the declared values of assets depending on whether he was seeking loans, buying insurance for his properties, or paying taxes on them. In short, if proven, it could amount to a whole lot of several types of fraud. During his questioning, several lawmakers asked him to elaborate.
To your knowledge, did the president ever provide inflated assets to an insurance company?
Yes.
Who else knows that the president did this?
Alan Weisselberg, Ron Lieberman, and Matthew Calamari.
And where would the committee find more information on this? Do you think we need to review his financial statements and his tax returns in order to compare them?
Yes, and you'd find it at the Trump Org.
Or Deutsche Bank, perhaps. The New York inquiry is a civil matter. It's not a criminal one, it's important to point out, and it joins a long list of other investigations surrounding the president of the campaign, transition, inauguration, administration, as well as his now defunct so-called charity, which the state of New York ordered dissolved. Like we said, he almost made it through a whole day without tweeting about any of it, but he didn't.